So what do you think is the way forward now as far as this is concerned?
Well, the first...
Because you have said we shouldn't panic.
Yeah, we shouldn't panic. We just need to look inwards. This moment, like I said, if we panic, we will create uncertainty. You understand? And there was something the government has done in line with not accepting to panic. And I will commend the government. I'm ready to have a national debate with anybody. That thing the government did of not panicking is its refusal to devaluate the Naira. That was now at the level of government, that was one good method or good measure. You know, if we had devaluated, and if there is any plan to devaluate the Naira, then I'm advising personally as Zaka Bala or Bala Zaka that it will be a very big mistake. You can only devalue your currency and benefit from the devaluation if you are producing goods and services. And let me give you a practical and an elementary example. And I can use names of countries. Let's take the United States, for instance. If tomorrow you hear that the United States dollar has gone down, it has been devalued, that means you can easily go there and have good health care. You can easily go there and buy goods because the value of the dollar has gone down. You can go there for education because the value has gone down. That means you can take few naira, go there, enjoy education, enjoy so many things, right? Take that and just superimpose it on Nigeria. If you devalue the naira today, what are the services you want to sell that will make people to come into your country and buy?
Services enough to stimulate the economy.
Yeah.
Keep activities going.
What are those services that people will come here to get? You find out that it's nothing. Zero. You will only be subsidizing the wrong thing. You will just be subsidizing the dollar. If you talk about China, Japan, and the rest, if you hear that their currency has gone low, you will see people rushing to China, to Japan, to Germany, to do what? To buy goods. So if you go there to buy goods because their currency has gone low. Mm. But in the case of Nigeria, if you devaluate it, where are the goods you have to sell? Do you have tomato paste that you want to sell? Do you have leather that people will come and buy here? Do you have the chocolate that you want to sell? Do you have the juices that people will come and buy? Do you have good educational system that will make people to say, oh, Nigerian currency has been devalued. Let more people come to Nigeria and school. Do you have good health services that people will say, whoa, the cost of health is cheap now in Nigeria. Let us go and patronize Nigerian healthcare system. So what is happening is, if you don't have goods and services to sell or to produce and sell, devaluing your currency will be at your own peril. And because you are an import-dependent country, if you devalue your currency today, tomorrow you will need more naira to go out and do what? And import. So the government has accepted, or the government took one bold step of refusing to panic. Because about a month or some weeks ago, there were waves of panic when IMF was to come.
That was real pressure.
And the pressure was for Nigeria to do what? To devalue the currency. And one thing again is this. In the face of all like this, the reason why we say people shouldn't panic is sometimes all we are just saying is back up a little and look at how that thing will destroy us. And
the point of
that, it will not do anything. So the artificial scarcity of dollars that has made our naira to be depreciating, it has not been devalued, to be floating and to be looking as if it is 300 naira to a dollar. If you ask me, the panic was created by basic economic traitors. We have genuine investors. We have genuine manufacturers. But tell me the volume of goods and services we wanted to start producing in Nigeria that all of a sudden invoked the need for so much dollars that created this panic.
Right.
You find out that it's actually artificial.
Mm. Balazaka, thank you for coming on the program and thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, we've been taking a look at the oil and gas and implication on the Nigerian economy and how they're affecting prices. We've been talking with oil and gas expert Balazaka. Now it's time to take a look at the dailies. Doshimabu is at the newspaper stand in Abuja.